Hi guys, I know this update is really way overdue. I have a lot to share with you and hopefully you'll understand why it took me so long to make a video. The last video I posted, I told you the chemo was going awesome and my tumor had shrunk by 75%, which was all true at the time. I then switched over to a new type of chemo in the taxane family called nab-paclitaxel. Some of you asked why, if that chemo is working, why would they switch you? The reason is because when you are on a really heavy, dose dense, toxic cocktail like I was, you can only do it for so long. That's why when cancer reoccurs and you've already gone through chemo and radiation and surgery, sometimes the doctors will tell you there's nothing else we can do because they can't keep giving you chemo. You can only get radiation one time in your life, you know, wherever the initial spot was for your cancer. So, you know, these are kind of like one-time bomb treatments. You know, they drop the bomb and either it works or it doesn't. So in my case, it was time to switch to a new type of chemo, which is very typical with someone with triple negative. Switching to a taxane in the second half of their chemo regimen is very common. So by the third week of switching to that, I knew that the tumor was growing. My tumor, because of the lumpectomies and the reincision I had received last year, I was able to actually see it was right underneath my skin of my breast. So it was actually visibly noticeable. And because I did not have surgery first to get rid of the tumor, I was able to know if the chemo was working or not. So yes, that first cocktail was working. If I could have handled it from a toxicity level and kept doing the other type of chemo, then, you know, maybe it would have completely died and just turned to scar tissue, but I did not have enough rounds of that to make that happen. So when I switched to the nab-paclitaxel, which by the way is considered a last line chemo, meaning people have tried everything else and then they switch them to nab-paclitaxel because it's more bio-recognizable by the body. So by the third week, though, my tumor was growing again. Now, there was a smaller tumor along the surgical line that had recurred, and there was cancer in my lymph nodes. Those seemed to have completely disappeared with the initial chemotherapy. But the main tumor was, you know, was recurring again, was growing again. Recurring is the wrong word because it was never totally gone. So it was started growing back again. So I went into my oncologist and she's like, yep, it's definitely growing. You're not doing chemo anymore. Plus I was getting really horrible side effects from that taxane. A lot of muscle and hand problems, which I'm still kind of having. So anyway, so that day she's like, you're not doing chemo anymore and you're getting a radical mastectomy done. Now you need to understand, radical mastectomy, double mastectomy was always a possibility, but because my other type of chemo was going so well, she was like, look, we might just have to go in there and, you know, get rid of the dead cancer cell, the dead cancer tissue with a lumpectomy, and you might just have to do radiation and then you'll be done. So there, that was a possibility. We went from that to, you're getting a radical mastectomy on the right side. They did not want to touch the left breast because there's nothing indicating any type of cancer anywhere in the left breast. And as far as reconstruction goes, it's easier, according to them, it really doesn't make much sense to me, but it's easier to reconstruct the right breast if the left breast is still intact, whatever. So I had to see the plastic surgeon because I was freaking out because if you know me personally or if you've seen any of my like wedding pictures, whatever, I have very large breasts. They are bigger than a double D. So I was very concerned about the aesthetics. So they went ahead and decided that they would do the radical mastectomy and reduce the left breast on the same day. Recovery from this was painful. Painful, painful, painful. Part of the pain is because they remove more of your lymph. They removed more of my lymph nodes. They removed lymph nodes last year. They removed more this year. It just causes a lot of pain. Lost scar tissue. I can still only like put my arm. You can't even see. Like maybe that high. It's super tight. We moved in the middle of all this. We did not know I was going to be getting surgery. We thought I'd still be on chemo for the move. We had a move in the middle of this, which is why we're in my kitchen, which is still not totally put together. Okay, so besides the pain, I could not even stand up straight because I had like lymphedema of the chest, which was causing a lot of lymph fluid to build up on that right side. So it was hard for me to stand up straight without it feeling like it was pulling. And it's just been a really hard recovery, but more than anything, psychologically, I was not prepared. My whole life, ever since I hit, fifth grade and started growing breasts, my breasts have been large, and people my whole life have commented on them. And that was just part of my world, but I didn't care about my breasts either way, which, of course, if you have breasts, you don't care about it. If you don't have breasts, you obsess your whole life about wanting them. But for me, they were just part of me. It was just, that's how I looked, whatever. I didn't think I cared if I had breasts or not. Well, when I got my mastectomy and I started, realizing, oh my gosh, like my breast really made my body more proportionate, whether I was overweight or not. Every single shirt that I have doesn't fit right now. Because, when I bought clothes, to flatter my body, and part of that was my breast. And I have to get radiation starting next week. It's supposed to start this week, but they didn't finish the mapping or something. So I have like these foam inserts, which kind of help, but they don't have the same weight and fluidity of a breast. So, they only look right in certain clothes. But I can't get a prosthetic yet because during radiation, they don't really want you wearing anything. Like just like a tank top, because your skin can get so denatured and burnt. If you're curious, you can look up radiation, breast cancer burns. It's not pretty. I'm doing a lot of homeopathic things, hopefully to keep my skin intact. It was just like psychologically, I'm still not in a great place about it. Some of you might think, well, what's the big deal? You'll just get fake boobs or something. Well, it doesn't really work like that after radiation. A lot of women that you see who have breast cancer and that get fake boobs, they're like stage one. They get a double mastectomy and the same day they stick implants in. They don't need radiation. They don't need chemo. Okay. So some women do get implants and then receive radiation, which can end up not being a good result as far as like what happens to the skin. The point is, every breast cancer story is different. So you might think it's just a matter of, chop your breast off, stick another one in, but it's not that simple. In my case, they did not want to put an implant in because they really want the radiation to take effect of this area and to really hopefully kill any rogue triple negative breast cancer cells that are in there. Because even before I had this mastectomy, they were worried that the radiation machine wouldn't be able to get good coverage of the entire breast area because they were so large. There are my case about losing weight, but I'm not allowed to lose weight during radiation. There's been studies that say women who maintain whatever weight they start radiation at do better than people who lose it during radiation. But the plastic surgeon wants me getting to the exact weight that I want to maintain the rest of my life. No more yo-yoing, because it will help her be able to construct a breast out of my own tissue that isn't going to look weird if I go up or down, basically. So psychologically, I'm just totally upside down. I'm supposed to start radiation next week. I still haven't heard from them. I have to call them in an hour or two. I was supposed to start this week. I don't know what they're doing. Cancer is a real pain in the ass. The treatments are horrific, barbaric. I did get through chemo, and I need to make a video about how I actually got through chemo, because for people who are going through chemo, I think what I did was very helpful. It's not something that most of your doctors are going to talk to you about, and it's not what you might be thinking, like, you know, popping some vitamins or something. So I've been leery about making that video just because it's like, well, it's a little controversial, even though it's been proven, but it definitely helped me. So I will have to make that video. So, and I will then make a video about how I get through radiation, because I am totally obsessed with my skin not getting ruined. Not just so that I can get reconstruction, but just I don't want my skin ruined during radiation. So, it's just, this is, you know, this is hard for me, guys. Like, doing chemo, radiation, all this stuff, you know. And if you would have told me 2 years ago, you're going to have breast cancer and you're going to do conventional treatments, I would have told you were crazy. You were nuts. That's not who I am. And then to have tried to do the alternative thing and then just had the breast cancer keep coming back. And it's honestly, the traditional stuff, whatever you want to call it, the conventional stuff's not working very well either. I mean, I've had surgery. It recurred. You know, I had chemo. It never totally went away. It was getting much better. New type of chemo, it started growing again. So I really haven't had success with the alternative or the conventional. My fingers are crossed that radiation will finally tear down any cancer cells and stop their little program from reproducing. We will see. So this video is pretty long. I'm going to do my best to keep you guys updated more consistently. It's just very difficult. I mean, I haven't even been talking to my real life friends and family. I've been kind of keeping my distance because I just have been in such a dark place emotionally. I didn't have much to say to anyone, and I needed to really work through it. And I'm still working through it. So health and happiness to you. Take care of yourselves, and I'll talk to you soon.